Okay, hi everybody, this is Joseph VStalin here, and I've come back from my electroshock therapy, and I don't remember most of who I was beforehand. Most of my memories have been entirely destroyed, but I did, however, leave a note for myself with a couple things that I would need to know. It says my real name. It says my alias, which is Joseph VStalin. It says I run a YouTube channel. I'm a member of www.gamerboot.com. And it also says I'm incredibly intelligent and incredibly good looking. But under that, it says in big star bold letters, please, whatever you do, make sure you keep making Let's Plays, but do not return to your Let's Play of Stalin vs. the Martians. Make sure you never ever touch that game again. Make sure you never ever finish that Let's Play. Make sure you just burn everything that ever touched the face of this game. But, I gotta admit, in all honesty, curiosity got the better of me. So, I decided that I would see what was so terrible about this game, and I would pick it up where I left off and see if I could finish this Let's Play and discover, you know, maybe a little bit more about who I was and why this was so terrible. Not to mention, I don't remember a single thing about this Stalin fellow, so I figured the best way for me to remember would be playing his game. So, without further ado, I'm going to continue from the first possible spot, which looks like it's going to be Mission 9. Sakharov the Bomberman, my fellow commander, first of all I must congratulate you on your destruction of the intelligent slime. What the fuck's the intelligent slime? Maybe I should have watched the first parts before I got back into this, but it's too late now. I will soldier on, trying to fill in the gaps in my foggy mind. A very good job indeed. Reminds me of the good old days when you did the same thing with the intelligentsia. Now, the guys over the KGB have investigated the area and found some secret alien portal that's protected by some kind of alien gate that's impenetrable to our conventional weaponry. But what they do not know about is our secret weapon, developed by Tavadish Sakharov. I am hereby extracting the famous scientist from his comfortable laboratory in the Gulag and sending him to aid you in this mission. Escort him to the alien gates and protect him along the way. He's a weakling like all intelligentsia and will be easily killed by the enemy. Good luck, Commander, and destroy the gates and reach the portal. Your god, Stalin. Well, this Stalin fella seems like he's a nice enough guy. I mean, he's a little arrogant, but I mean, he congratulated me and he was all thinking, you know, I was pretty cool. So, all in all, he seems like, first impression, he seems like a nice guy. I mean, you kind of have to be a clown to disagree with that, I would think. But, let's see what we got here. Oh my god, man, I'm just getting rushed. I'm getting rushed by these pink, yellow, just multicolored men. I don't know, it looks like they belong in some kind of, like, six-year-old's birthday party or something. But, I'm just kind of letting instinct take over from, and doing what, just kind of shutting off my mind and letting my hands take over all the work and do what they can. Well, I should probably move this guy down here so I don't... And yeah, but I guess first impression of the game, I think it's it looks nice and colorful and it's easy. I mean, considering this is the first RTS game I have any recollect playing, I think it could be a lot worse. I mean, it looks all pretty and colorful, and it's genius in a way. It's genius in it's unresponsive controls and loose maneuvering and terrible AI. I mean, this is somewhere in this mess. There's genius hidden here, and I respect that. I respect that greatly. In this hidden genius, it makes me have a little bit more respect for everything. Also, I mean, purple frogs in the game, that's just incredible. I mean, I don't understand how someone could come up with such a pinnacle of intellect to put purple frogs in this game. It just baffles me how intelligent these people must have been who created this game to decide that, you know, that they were going to put purple frogs in it. Because I couldn't have come up with something like that. Could you? I certainly couldn't. So where is my right to criticize these people? So, first verdict on Stalin vs. the Martians, it's pretty damn good. In fact, considering that it's the only game that I have any recollect playing, it is the best game I've ever played. But I guess that is by default, so maybe we should take it with a grain of salt, but, I mean, you know, it could be a lot worse. I could be playing, you know, Metal Gear Solid 4 or something. Ugh. That's another note I left for myself. It says Metal Gear Solid 4 is a terrible game. So I thought I may as well reference that, because, you know, if I used to think it was terrible, then everyone must think that game is terrible. So hopefully, you know, I won't get total flack for referencing the atrocity that game was, and saying that without a doubt, Stalin vs. the Martians is a far superior game. So, in terms of what I'm actually supposed to be doing, I believe I'm supposed to be moving this guy to his position at the gate. Hold on, I saw a green guy who was firing at one of my troops. Just gonna make sure this little guy doesn't, he makes it all right. I mean, he's what I'm supposed to be protecting after all. But I mean, although he does walk awfully, awfully slowly. You know, for all the genius that Stalin vs. the Martians is, as ingenious, as incredible as this game is, watching this guy walk slowly towards the gate is kind of boring, so I'm going to skip ahead until I have something more substantial. Alright, so we're right back where we just left off, and this little dude here is walking towards the gate where we're apparently going to open the portal and visit the alien world and destroy them, and I'm guessing we're ridding them from the Russians. And I have been doing a little bit of research on who I once was, and I'm starting to regain a bit more of my consciousness and remove some of the fogginess that is clouding my head. I do know that I did speak two languages, however I do not remember any of them, which is quite depressing. But it looks like our dude has reached the gate, but I've also been researching things like my game tastes and my musical tastes, so I'm starting to get a little bit more of who I once was. And hopefully I'll be able to bring the same caliber of consciousness to the videos I once was. But what am I supposed to be doing? this guy supposed to come with us? I guess so. I wish he did not walk so slow. You know, maybe this game isn't as genius as I once thought it was. I mean, it is pretty awesome in all fairness, but just this guy walks so goddamn slowly that it makes you want to smack something. And in all honesty, maybe it's getting me a little bit frustrated, but I guess I gotta forgive the game, because I mean, I'm in no place to judge, you know, because I haven't played any other games. So as far as I know, this is the greatest game ever created. So please, yes, there he goes. Okay, all right, gay. Okay.